Let's discuss about power of a wave. We can simply define power as the energy transferred per unit time by the wave. The total amount of energy which is transferred or propagating along the wave in 1 second or per unit time is defined as power. We just talk about a simple harmonic wave in a media. If we draw the displacement curve of the wave, say wave is propagating at a speed v, and in this situation all medium particles oscillate with amplitude a and say angular frequency omega. In this situation we know that for a transverse wave each medium particle oscillates up and down, and in case of sound waves each medium particle oscillate along the direction of energy flow about their own mean position. They are not displaced, but energy flows through each medium particle. In this situation, if wave is propagating at a speed v, we can say if oscillator placed at origin is started at t equal to 0, then up to say t equals to 1 second, it will travel, the wave will travel up to a distance of v meter as its speed is v. That means all the medium particles from origin or from the point of oscillator to the length of v meter will start oscillating with the same amplitude a. And we know that oscillation energy for simple harmonic motion is given as half m omega square a square. If a particle of mass m oscillates with angular frequency omega and amplitude a. So in this situation we can simply define power of wave. It is oscillation energy supplied to v meter length of medium. In 1 second, as the energy is supplied which has traveled a distance of v meter, that means all medium particles which are oscillating in the v meter length will be carrying the total energy which is supplied in 1 second. So we can directly write this power is equals to, if the mass per unit length or linear mass density of the medium is taken as mu, which is generally written as density multiplied by the cross sectional area. In this situation wave power can be written as the total energy of v meter length, which will be having a mass given as mu v multiplied by omega square a square. If we substitute the linear mass density as density into cross sectional area, this power can be written as half rho s v omega square a square. And here omega can also be written as 2 pi n if n is the oscillation frequency. So in this situation, this we write it as 2 pi n, this will be 2 pi square n square a square rho v s. This is the expression we use for power of a wave. Power of a simple harmonic wave which is having amplitude a and frequency s, which is propagating in a medium of density rho with the speed v, and the area of cross section of medium taking part in wave motion is s. Let us now continue our discussion on wave intensity. Wave intensity is defined as power per unit cross sectional area. This is the cross sectional area of the region in which the wave propagation is taking place. As in previous section we have studied about the power of wave, here we can directly write the wave intensity I as P by S, if S is the cross sectional area through which the power P is propagating. And obviously as it is power per unit area, its units unit can be defined as watt per meter square. So here if we substitute the expression for power we have just now studied, it is 2 pi square n square a square rho v s divided by s. Here s gets cancelled out, and the wave intensity here we can write I is equals to 2 pi square n square a square rho v. This is the expression we'll use for wave intensity. And here we can write, for a given medium in which if two different waves are propagating, then for a given medium, the medium density and the wave velocity remain constant. And here we can write intensity is proportional to n square and intensity is proportional to a square. And using this here we can write, for the two waves I1 by I2 is equals to n1 square a1 square by n2 square a2 square. So, this is the way how we can compare the intensity of two waves in a given medium if their frequency and amplitude are known. So, here we can also write that the expression for power and intensity we have used, we can write that both the expressions of power and intensity are valid for all kind of simple harmonic waves. These are simple harmonic waves we will study, which are light as well as sound waves. So for all simple harmonic waves, this is the way how we get the intensity as well as the power of wave which we have taken up in the previous slide.